Are we good? We live? Okay, apparently we're live. Alright, yeah, so I guess I would like to welcome everybody to the live stream. Obviously, Paris Games Week is not too far away. Sony's going to have the live stream press conference. So, yeah, hopefully you guys stay tuned for the content. And, yeah, if you guys are watching this later on in the day, this will be just a normal video for you guys, but yeah, we're gonna get stuck into it and yeah, watch whatever Sony's gonna do live. I think it's gonna happen in the next 12 minutes, so yeah, we'll just see how that goes, because I think for memory it was supposed to be a 2 o'clock start, but it's 4:06 over for that, so maybe it's 2:06 for us. Because yeah, definitely had to put in some effort to make sure I was actually up for this, because it's pretty much 2 o'clock in the morning right now over here. Hopefully I see you guys in the chat. If you guys want to put down your predictions or anything like that, please be free to do any of that. And yeah, just hopefully we have a good stream. Yep, I think we should be ready to go, so yeah, so it's just going to be interesting to see what they show. Obviously, Detroit Become Human is probably going to be a big part. Haven't heard anything of Wild. I think they'll probably show something of that. Yeah, it's definitely going to be interesting to see where they go with it. So whether if they are... Oh, man. I mean, as I said, if you guys have any predictions, let me know so I can... go through with you guys and we can have discussions and stuff, but yeah, no, pretty excited about this one. They are also they were actually kind of hyping it up during this week as well. They were saying something like, I think it was like E3 was only half the games they wanted to announce, so I mean, it's a big thing to say, but at the same time, who knows, maybe they might be right. Maybe, is that, alright, that's it. Alright, good. So now, I don't think there should be any lag anymore. Yep. So we should be alright with that. And, yeah, we should be good to go. So as I said, if you have anything you want to put into the chat, like a prediction or, yeah, feel free to put it in the chat. And yeah, I just need to make sure that I'm not streaming this video multiple times, because that was what went wrong last time. And pretty much every other time I've tried to live stream, something went wrong. But nah, we should be pretty good now. Damn, we actually have 4 viewers at the moment. Yeah, we'd like to welcome everybody to the stream. Hopefully you guys will enjoy not only the content, but obviously the press conference is going to happen, which I assume it's going to happen in the next, I want to say, 9 minutes. So, as I said, put whatever predictions you have in the chat, if you have not already, and yeah, let's just have some fun tonight. But yeah, as I said, Detroit Become Human is probably going to play a big part. I don't think it'll be their main thing. I've just got a feeling something else is probably going to be their main thing. But given that it's in Paris, that's Detroit Become Human's like location of like where it's been made. So because it's got a home ground advantage, if you want to say, or if I want to say, for a sporting term, it's probably going to be a good pop for it to do well for that. So I wouldn't be surprised if you see a lot of that in this. What else are we going to say? I don't think we'll see God of War. That just seems more of a PlayStation experience sort of thing, because it's just too... It just has too much of a PlayStation name to it to not have it a PlayStation experience. It's not going to be coming out. Or, speaking of coming out soon, the Horizon Zero Dawn DLC is going to be coming out, I think, middle of the next month. Because obviously tomorrow will be starting off November. Well, it's the 31st here anyway, but... Horizon Zero Dawn isn't too far away either, so... Maybe we'll get some footage of that. Because we haven't even got footage of that yet, so... We'll see how we go with that. Just trying to list off games that we haven't seen in a while that we might see. Definitely Wild. I reckon Wild will probably be on in this press conference. We haven't heard anything of Dreams yet for a long time. Like, I think it's been a good, God, I want to say 18 months we haven't seen Dreams for, so, like, at least. So maybe we might get an update on that, if it has a release date or not, because, I mean, that's been, I want to say they teased that. Didn't they tease that pretty much? I don't think they teased it right from the start, but it wasn't far off if it wasn't. I want to say maybe within the first year. I think the year it came out, the following E3, so maybe E3 2014, I think, was announced. So, I mean, that's been, what, 3 years it's been around. So that's been around for a while, so maybe we might get some information on that. Yeah, it's interesting. Yeah, as I said, feel free to have a talk in the chat and do some predictions, do some whatever you feel you need to get off your chest before the press conference starts. Feel free to do it in the chat. Just trying to think. And then there's, like, obviously new titles. I don't think we'll see Sucker Punch's new game, because obviously with Sucker Punch, they're probably not too far away to show their game. That's probably maybe a PSX thing, because, I mean, and given that it's a new IP, maybe it might be on Paris Games Week, because maybe Sony may think that it doesn't have a big presence like they probably want it to have. But at the same time, who knows? And then, like, I guess if you look at any games that came out, probably, I want to say 2014, 2015, probably maybe look at getting sequels. So maybe that could be a chance. Not too sure with Ready at Dawn, with how they had the Order 1886. Because I think Sony owns the IP for memory, so... and I think I was hearing articles that they weren't too happy with the last one, so maybe... Ready at Dawn maybe may not be making it, but who knows, maybe there might be an Order 1887, which would be technically, I mean, if they named it that would definitely be a sequel. It's definitely going to be interesting to see how we go. And I think we should be 3 minutes away, so definitely not far away at all. Just trying to think of, like, I mean, Ratchet and Clank, I don't think... Has that been long enough? That came out April. Was that April last year, or was that April the year before? Let me look that up real quick. So it was last year. So we probably won't get any information on that. That might be PSX probably next year. Because that's been... Yeah, it's only been about a year and a half, so that probably isn't long enough. Probably need about 2.5 years of development just to probably get people to, to have enough development time to actually have enough, game to develop to actually show something. So maybe that might be next PSX. What came out in 2015? In 2014 that we haven't had sequels yet to. I mean, those are probably the games that would probably be on the radar. Because there was The Order, we had... The Order was 2015. There was another one, because wasn't there one that came out in February and one that came out in March that were two exclusives? I'm trying to think of what the other one was. Let's see if there's like a list on Google for PlayStation exclusives. See if there's like a list, because that'd be some of them didn't. I mean, we have had some exclusives that have done well, but we've also had some that haven't done as well. Because even with the Order, like I had, it wasn't obviously the best game going around, but it definitely had a lot of things it done right. Alright, here we go. Paris Games Week. We're now getting started.
Hey everybody, PlayStation's live at Paris Games Week 2017. We've got a huge show for you starting now.
Alright, let's go. Let's get hyped. Let's watch this. They didn't even talk about the 7 games that were going to be announced, or 8 games that were going to be announced. Yeah, nothing new on that, I don't think. So far it seems to... Nothing's jumped out yet. I'm actually kind of excited, actually, low-key.
Welcome to PlayStation Live from Paris Games Week. We've got a big, big show for you here today. Lots to talk about. But first, I want to introduce our crew, starting with you. And you've got a very familiar face.
Really?
Yes.
Where have you seen me before?
Maybe the internet.
The internet?
Yes.
YouTube, perhaps?
Perhaps.
Well, you might have seen me on PlayStation Access in my little YouTube cupboard. This is like this is a real treat to be somewhere as glamorous as this. We've got like an actual desk. lovely backdrop. Like, this has got all the bells and whistles. You know, we're not as big budget as this, are we? I've got my PlayStation Access partner in crime with me as well.
Why, hello, Holly.
The amazing Hi. Holly Bennett.
Yeah, they've also let me out of the cupboard for a while. This is really exciting that we're allowed to have such a fancy arena. For anyone who doesn't know, myself and Rob team up with three others to make PlayStation Access, which is a YouTube channel. We're based in the UK, but we make content for everyone.
Yep.
And we literally cover everything from the world of PlayStation. We eat, sleep, and breathe PlayStation.
What's coming up next for PlayStation Access?
Well, I mean, anyone who follows me on Twitter probably knows I've just come back from Japan. But it is a secret, actually. We can't tell you just yet what we're working on, but very soon those videos will be going
live.
It's
going to be very exciting.
It's soon. Amazing.
Yeah, I like subscribe now. And yes, rounding out our host here, Mr. Ramon Russell, the heartthrob of San Diego studio. I'm so glad you could join us, bud.
I'm glad y'all could have us. I really appreciate it.
Yeah.
Like Sid said, my name is Ramon Russell. I am from the MLB The Show development team back in San Diego. Speaking of them, shout out to everybody, all our development team back at home, cranking away on MLB The Show 18.
Yeah,
we can't wait to tell you about it,
but
not today. Today, we're going to talk about all of this awesome content coming to PlayStation 4.
That's right. Now, tell me a little bit about what you do with the MLB team. I know you do some streaming. Tell me a little bit about that.
Right. So I do a little bit of everything. Most of the people on our development teams, we wear many, many hats. I'm a game designer sometimes. Other times, I'm a community guy. And other times, I'm here in Paris with you guys on this stage, ready to see some really awesome content.
And really awesome content we are going to see starting any minute now. I want to tell you a little bit about what we've got lined up tonight. We're going to have 20 plus game updates. We're going to have 7 game reveals, and we are going to be covering a wide spectrum.
That's
AAA games. We're going to have independent big ones. We're going to have DLC updates for major titles, big sequels, Final Fantasy updates. I mean, my goodness gracious. And then the PlayStation Media Showcase, and who knows what's going on there. That's just under an hour from now. We've got a lot to get to tonight, and I say, if it's okay with you guys, that we dive right in, and we start off with a reveal. Now, this is a sequel to a game that a lot of people really love, and I want to show the first gameplay of that, and we're going to do that right now.
Okay, so we're kicking off with the pre-show.
After 1,000 years, the Mask of Vengeance has manifested itself again. Who will protect the Mexiverse against the powers of evil?
Guacamelee.
A hero with determination, who doesn't crack under pressure. With a statuesque poise of the old gods.
I've been trying to finish this game so many times. I need to get on top of this. Hey, Guacamelee. So is this a sequel? Damn, that looks actually pretty good. Guacamelee too, Alright, I'm pretty happy about that.
Guacamelee 2 kicking this off right. I love the first game. So excited to see the Drink Box is back with a sequel.
You
coming to PS4 soonish.
I love how precise they put in the release date.
I'll tell you
it. Getting us really excited.
I
struggle
to get back into it. There's a 99% chance it'll come out.
Soonish. And we are going to see some more gameplay of that nowish. And this game is looking super, super polished.
You saved that one, you didn't show us that in rehearsal.
That's right.
I keep saving that one up.
I kept that in my back pocket. So this game is looking super polished, and what we're seeing here, I believe these are the dimensional waves, right?
Yeah, and they allow you to solve puzzles and traverse obstacles. And you can see there, like, there's some hazards in the red dimension, and he's safe in the blue one.
Awesome.
It's going to add like a really interesting angle to the puzzling.
Now, if you played the original Guacamelee, you know it's got a robust combat system, and we're going to see a little bit of that here, juggling with those dimensional waves. But, you know, the combat in this game is just so satisfying. You've got these luchador, sort of pro wrestling moves mixed up with sort of beat-em-up combat, and that color palette, rounding it all out.
That looks gorgeous, doesn't it?
Yeah, I just hope the waves don't become faster. I mean, that's the only problem I can see with it.
And I remember I sucked badly at the first one.
Yeah.
I was not good at it.
Chicken!
Okay, so
this is what we're here for.
This is what we're here for. The chicken is back and better than ever. And this chicken has seen a lot of refinement, a lot of new chicken mechanics on deck here for Guacamelee 2 coming to PS4. And
this is what they've been spending all their time on.
I mean, why not? Yeah. Right?
I mean, wouldn't you? Kong's good.
So this chicken here,
I don't know if this is the first one because I didn't get
quite a tough customer. We're gonna see that here in a second, but right now we're gonna see a new ability unlocked by, I can only presume,
the chicken oracle.
Yeah,
the
chicken oracle.
I swear that is a fried chicken shop somewhere in South London.
If it's not, it certainly should be.
He's telling him, do not get turned into chicken nuggets today.
That's
not
right.
Not today, son.
You're going to learn some new abilities.
Well, he isn't going to get turned into chicken nuggets for this.
Chicken shot. This is a new ability here for the chicken. This chicken is really a can-do
it's
chicken.
It's actually kind of cool, and actually.
This chicken shot, the chicken glide, we're seeing it all here. Now, this chicken shot is also useful in combat. So this chicken is a ferocious, ferocious fighter.
Crazy.
Guacamelee too. I love that.
I mean, you would not want to mess with this chicken. Look at it go.
All chickens in video games are ferocious. I've learned that through my years of gaming.
A murderous force.
That's right.
Chickens are nasty.
This has got to be the most lethal looking chicken I've seen.
Seeing some first gameplay here at Guacamelee 2, and is this
co-op?
Is this co-op?
Yes. It's co-op.
So I do have it on good authority from Drinkbox that there is 4-player co-op throughout the entire game. We're seeing 3 of those 4 players right now, and this is the mangrove swamp level.
I can't wait for you guys to carry me.
grappling hook mechanic here, looking great.
It's
Guacamelee 2. Wow, great start here for tonight. And you know something? Let's just keep going. I got 2 more announcements, and we're going to get to both of those right now.
All right, let's see. Oh, this is Last Light. No, not Last Light. It's like a side scroller. Can't remember what it was called though. Or is it? Or is it something else? Maybe it's something else. It looks really good though. Okay, that must be new. Because I don't think I've seen that before. This looks like it's new as well. It's got a pretty cool art style.
We just got to look at. I got to say, the Gardens Between looking awesome. It's got that art style. It's got the time mechanics. Holly, what do you make of that?
That is completely my type of game. I'm honestly taken with it. I have goosebumps every time that music drops. It's a beautiful single-player narrative-driven puzzle game, but there's no time pressure on the puzzles, and I really like that. No text or dialogue. The world tells you the story. One button to interact, a lovely game to get into.
Really, one button?
Genuinely in love with it. And it comes out late 2018.
Nice. So the first trailer that we saw, that was the Hong Kong Massacre, developed by Vresky. Super stylistic trailer that looked insane. It had this like Max Payne,
Hotline Miami,
yeah. A little Blade Runner vibe.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
You can expect that coming to the PlayStation 4 in 2018.
Outstanding. So we're going to keep moving here. We got a lot to get to, and frankly, we're running behind. So LocoRoco Remastered, it's out now on PS4. We know LocoRoco 2 Remastered's coming, and right now we're going to tell you when.
Like Elvin and the Chipmunks? Like, what is this?
And that was Loco 2 Remastered, and that's coming out December 9th, finally, now we know. Holly, I know this is a big one for you.
My bathroom is actually decorated with LocoRoco stickers.
She's not even joking.
I'm not actually joking. I loved both LocoRoco games, my PlayStation Portable, my PSP, played them nonstop. I love eating. And me and the LocoRoco games have that in common. If you've never played LocoRoco before, you play this lovely little creature, you roll around, you eat the flowers, you get bigger, you complete puzzles, sometimes you have to be a certain size to be able to complete them, and you sing to wake up magical creatures. It's utterly charming. I basically love LocoRoco. So LocoRoco 2, there's going to be new collectibles, new characters. It's in 4K on PlayStation 4 Pro. And pre-order start today.
Outstanding.
Nice.
So Holly, I know you're also a big fan of The Sims.
Yeah.
And I think we've got an update on that one.
Yes, we do. We know The Sims 4 is coming to PS4 in November. I'm, like you said, a huge fan. So we have a first look at the expansions that are coming soon. So I say we just check it out.
You can definitely miss The Sims 4 as well. At least so far,
And that was The Sims 4. It's coming out November on PS4. And now I have a confession to make. I've actually never played a Sims game.
Are you for real?
Yes. 20 years almost.
Shame.
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 Shame. Ring the bell.
I will say, I did get a chance to check it out on PS4. I spoke with the developer, and I think this might be the one for me. It's a time to dive in. So what they've done is they've basically tried to capture the entire Sims 4 experience from the PC, and instead of kind of reconstituting or boiling it down or doing something else with this is really the pure version, and it's been just reworked with the UI in mind. It's going to have a much easier UI than we've seen. It's going to have all the free updates that they've rolled out to the PC. So that's toddlers, you got your pools, your careers, and I have it on good authority that future PC free updates are also going to make the jump to PS4. So
it's good,
yeah,
to hear.
Good stuff.
I think that's really exciting. I think what's really important here, it's not a reimagining, it's not reconstituted. I think I last played The Herbs on PS2, and those games weren't like traditional Sims games, and that's really what people want. So, as Sid said, exact same game, but with PS4-friendly UI. That's what you want. And of course, it's launching with all the fan favorites like City Living and Vampires, etc.
Are you going to be cruel to your Sims, Holly?
Yeah, probably. I mean, it starts with about 3 hours of building a house, and then you're just cruel to them for the rest of it.
And lock them in a room with a refrigerator and a door to get out.
Don't give my secrets away.
Yeah. So hey, we're keeping a pretty quick pace on today's show, and we've got yet another game update to share with you right now. And Rob, I got the sense you were kind of fired up for this one.
I am massively excited about this one. When I first heard this was coming out, I literally was jumping for joy.
And Rob doesn't jump for anything.
No, not for anything. So I believe we're going to have a little look at Tennis World Tour. Let's check out the trailer right now.
Okay, so we got a tennis game now. coming to PS4 2018. Is this supposed to be arcade? Or is it supposed to be like a simulation?
And that was a new look at Tennis World Tour. It's coming to PS4 next year.
Rob,
thoughts?
I am super hyped for this. Holly can attest to this. I've been wanting a tennis game on PS4 for forever. Like it's been way too long since we've had a good, proper, deep tennis sim. Like the last one I really got stuck into was a Topspin 4 on PS3. I played that so much I was one trophy away from platinuming it. And I understand some of the devs from Topspin 4 are working on Tennis World Tour.
That's true.
And there's going to be, I think they've got 30 licensed players so far. There's a full-on career mode, and it's really focused on the simulation of it as well. So if you're after that deep, really sim-heavy tennis game, this is going to be the one for you. I think MLB has got some competition now. Simulation.
We'll fix this after the live stream.
we'll handle this after we're done.
Well, the excitement is palpable, and I want to just take a quick status check. Just take a moment to catch our breath here. PlayStation's media showcase here at Paris Games Week is just about 30 minutes away. So you know that's going to have some good stuff, and we're going to be cutting live to that right after this program. And we are running a bit behind. We've got a lot to get to. We've got a lot of announcements. We've got reveals, updates to share right here. And I want to kind of bring the conversation back to PlayStation VR because it's just celebrated its one-year birthday.
Pembloy's happy.
That's right. More than 100 games out there for PlayStation VR. Tons more due for 2018. Ramon, what's your favorite PSVR game?
Resident Evil.
Yeah?
Scared the living crap out of me. I played the first few minutes regular on my television, and I popped on PSVR. Completely different experience. I can't lie, I'm a scaredy cat, so I tried to get the shotgun and leave the house, but it didn't really work out.
Did you finish it?
I mean, if you're watching,
we're not going to talk about that today.
Rob didn't either.
It's way too scary, but a game I really enjoyed, and I'm not even a massive Trekkie, but I really enjoyed playing Star Trek Bridge Crew. We played it in the PlayStation Access office, four of us all playing. Yeah. You each have like a different role on the bridge. Like I was the helmsman, Dave was the captain, and you have to really coordinate to achieve your objectives, and it's like the ultimate wish fulfillment if you're a Star Trek fan, being able to be in Star Trek. It was just a really immersive experience, exactly what PlayStation VR is good at. Amazing game.
You literally did nothing but squabble. It was a video of you squabbling.
No, we didn't.
Now, while you like to sit, you know, quietly on the bridge, this is my jam. Give me a gun, give me giant alien spiders, and let me go to town on them. I really enjoyed Farpoint. I think as well it also had the aim controller. And I just had that feeling that if anyone should walk into a living room when I'm playing Farpoint, I might look slightly more badass while in my pajamas because I've at least got the aim controller. Played it in co-op as well, which just means you and a friend can bicker while you try and take on the aliens. It's everything I wanted.
Very exciting, but this is the highlight for me.
So
super hot VR.
Look at me. That.
Tiny Sid down there in the lower corner of your screen playing super hot VR. I loved it on PS4, but on PlayStation VR, just so immersive. Like we're all cackling like goons, you know, as I do all of this. Like I'm blasting these guys. I'm throwing ashtrays at them. I'm throwing phones at them. Dual wielding here like some sort of John Woo movie. It's just a riot. I mean, it's just pure fun. So much fun. And that's sort of some of the highlights for PlayStation VR that are out now. Enough about me, enough about us and our favorites. It's time to take a look at the future of PlayStation VR because there's a lot of great games coming. We've got two of them to share with you right this minute, so let's check it out.
All right, two games. PlayStation VR. And this new game, world debut. Okay. I mean, I guess I'm interested, but that's real.
It takes more than a fancy airship to make it in the arena. It takes a fearless captain and a steady crew. Join today and experience heart-stopping thrills.
Okay, it looks okay.
That was two brand new games revealed for PlayStation VR, both scheduled for release in 2018. Now, looking at Bout of Blood, Rob, you're a Star Trek Bridge Crew fan. I kind of thought that might be kind of up your alley.
I mean, for me, that's what PlayStation VR is amazing at, letting you experience things that you're never going to experience anywhere else. And so, piloting a really high-tech airship in Bout of Blood, yes, that is probably right up my alley. Like, it's a really unique game as well. It's set in this kind of fantasy reality TV show. We've got other contestants or enemies, and you can betray them or you can make allies with them. And also, it's procedurally generated as well. So every time you play Bout of Blood, you're going to be getting a completely new experience every time. But for me, it's just, you know, airships. Airships in VR. That's what it's about for me. Absolutely love it.
Yeah, I'm trying to that
there's also Megalith. We got a quick look at that one, Ramon. What do you think of that?
First trailer that we saw. So Megalith is actually an action-packed shooter.
Yes, it's a hero shooter. Yeah.
So you're a titan trying to become a giant god, has destructible environments, you get free locomotion. It's also coming out in 2018, and the development team behind it are full of multiplayer veterans, and they're excited about what they can do in VR, which also makes all of us excited, because with VR you're going to have totally new experiences, loads of innovation, so we can't wait to see what everybody's going to do.
Absolutely, and one of the great things about PlayStation VR is new experiences, but also putting a fresh perspective on familiar ones. So in that note, let's take a look at Ultra Wings VR coming to PSVR.
Ultra Wings. I do feel like the VR flying games should be one of the, I guess, immersive in games that you should probably get. Like, types of games you should get if you're going to get a PlayStation VR. So, I think this is good. It's okay. Actually pretty cool.
That sprint vector, my goodness, I've got the vapors. I mean, what do you make of that, Holly? Oh,
I loved it. It reminded me of a manga I used to be really into called Air Gear, just because of the rollerblading. As a game, it's already had tons of press attention. The devs have said, no, you can comfortably run, okay, jump, climb, and fly, because it's very action-packed on its obstacle courses. And they have something called fluid locomotion. That is what they're coining for this.
Fluid, indeed. And we also just checked out Ultra Wings VR. That's also coming to PlayStation VR. It's an open world VR flight game, lots of courses and challenges. Interesting that you use the PS moves to pilot the craft. bunch of different crafts. They're saying 30 hours or so to get all the gold medals, so
that's
robust experience there. Keeping it moving on the PlayStation VR front, we actually do have an update to share right now around a favorite that was announced at E3. Now, if you watched the E3 PlayStation Media Showcase, you saw a quirky, delightful little game called Moss.
Yay!
And we're delighted to say that this one is actually coming out February 2018, so we can finally announce that. Ramon, you got a chance to play it.
Yes, I did. The developers at PolyArc were so kind to send me a build that I got to play last week. I'm loving this game. So you control this mouse. Her name is Quill. She got this little sword, this awesome little like leaf thing on her arm, which is kind of cool. And what's really awesome about this game is the fact that you're using the analog sticks to control Quill, but when you're doing the puzzles in 3D space, you're actually using the motion controller on the DualShock 4 to grab
like cool things back.
Yes,
like so you're actually grabbing that block there.
Yep.
Man, it looks amazing.
I'm really
so you get to control both the kind of the puzzles and Quill at the same time.
Exactly, the exact same time. I really, really love this demo that they sent me. This game is going to be so awesome. I can't wait to play it. And it's a dungeon crawler with a little mouse.
It's a little tiny mouse named Quill. So cute. But yeah, I mean, I just, this is one of the things I just love about VR is just new ways to interact. I mean, that's kind of, I think, deep down what we all look for in gaming and something that PlayStation VR actually well positioned to provide.
Ooh, combat, right?
Here's a first look at some of the combat. So you see Quill's gonna take care of these little red beagles. So what's awesome is with the DualShock, you can freeze some of the enemies.
So you're doing both.
You're doing both at the same time.
That's cool.
And does
I like
it
that.
Feel like easy to do both at the same
yeah,
time?
Yeah, I didn't have trouble at all controlling Quill or some of the puzzles at the same time.
That's really nice.
So you're putting up
pull
some
those steps up,
there.
Turn them around, and control Quill to get her to run all the way up.
I would have played this nonstop if they sent me that demo.
That's awesome. So this is coming out February 2018. Pre-orders start very soon.
Wow.
That's right. Well, thank you for that hands-on report there, Ramon, on Moss. It's coming February 2018. Very excited about that one. Here's an update on another title that was announced for PlayStation VR at E3. That's Star Child. We've got a brand new trailer. And there's, well, I'll just leave it to the trailer. Let's check it out. Yeah.
Hi everyone, I'm Paul Bettner. I'm the founder and CEO at Playful.
And I'm Kynan Pearson, the director of Starchild. Starchild is a cinematic platforming adventure game. You play as Spectra, a traveler who crash lands on an alien planet during an important mission.
You're about to see one of Spectra's unique abilities here today for the first time. We hope you enjoy this global debut of our new trailer.
All right. Pretty interesting. Might need to look into that.
Brand new trailer for Star Child here. We just debuted, and I gotta admit, guys, I'm a little puzzled by this unique ability. Any ideas?
It's like,
what was
me
that?
With more like questions than
yeah,
I have
questions
answers.
Questions and answers in it. And
it looked like she was projecting herself out of her body and manipulating, like maybe astral projection. I want to say.
Is that sounds
good.
Cool?
All right. That sounds about right.
That sounds about right.
Maybe telekinesis.
Maybe. Yeah.
Something I guess we're just going to have to wait and see, huh? So lots more to come here on the show. And we haven't even gotten to the PlayStation Media Showcase, by the way. So we are going to have a big Final Fantasy update for you at home. We're going to have big update for more VR. We're going to have more game announcements. And then, of course, that PlayStation Media Showcase that's coming really, really soon. I want to check back Before we move on, though, on one of the year's biggest PlayStation VR titles.
Resi 7?
Yes!
Surely.
Resident Evil 7.
I mean, they don't come bigger than Resi 7 on VR, I don't think. And the exciting news is there is new free DLC for Resi 7 coming in December.
$3.99?
$3.99 is free. Even more exciting, it stars fan favorite Chris the Muscles Redfield. Everyone loves Chris Redfield. He's just, I mean, it's going to be an awesome new take on the Resi 7 formula, and it's entirely playable in VR, again, just like the main Resi 7 game. Redfield is like an action hero, so it's going to give a really different spin on the gameplay to Resi 7, I think, and we can have a look at the trailer for the Not a Hero DLC right now.
Lucas, you'll pay for this.
You're going to fail, and then you are going to die.
Right now, he's our only link to the connections.
He's next on my list.
We didn't get much from the first unit before we lost contact.
Luke is a fucking psycho. I'll show what's worse, him or those things. We gotta get out of here. Oh, fuck. You gotta be kidding me. Fuck! 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 Get this thing off me!
Oh, shit.
Please tell me what I'm looking at.
I have no idea. It's something new. Exercise extreme caution.
Christopher, stay away from Halsey. Very impressive, my friend. Very impressive. Let's just see how impressive you really are.
You're going to need to proceed with caution. Extreme caution.
Oh, that's different. Like I haven't been since we got here.
It's also kind of cool that it's like free content too. I guess it's technically not free content if you have to buy the gold edition, but...
Brand new look at Resident Evil 7's free Not a Hero DLC. Rob, I know you're a big fan of Resident Evil. I mean, it's one of the best of the year.
It is. I think it's in my top three of the year.
Yeah.
I spent the majority of Resident Evil 7 hiding and or running away from things. I think now I'm playing as Chris Redfield. I'm going to be punching stuff in the face.
Right in the face.
It's going to be awesome. Yeah.
Now, Ramon, I'm told you're a big fan of Halloween.
I most certainly am. I love Halloween. And actually, we have two PSVR games launching in time for Halloween. Let's take a look at this spooky pair.
It takes a jump.
Now teach you the ways of our art. What's next?
Hello?
Oh, I think I remember this. Was it like, wasn't this on like PC originally? Perception?
Thank you.
must be something different.
Wow. Two wildly different takes on the horror genre, I guess that's fair to say, right, Rob?
Yeah, I mean, Stifled looks absolutely terrifying. Also, like nothing I've ever seen either. From the trailer, it looks like you have to kind of make noise to paint a picture of the world around you, but at the same time, that noise could attract things that you don't quite want to be attracting.
Things to go bump in the night, maybe.
I think we should make Dave play it.
I think we should make Dave play it.
Absolutely love that game. If you're watching Dave, you're going to be playing Stifled very soon. Dead Hungry also looked awesome, though, Holly.
Dead Hungry, as we've already learned through my love of Loco Roco, suits me just fine because I enjoy food. It's from Pixel Junk, so you know it's kind of going to be crazy. The idea is the zombies are really hungry, so you're making fast food and literally lobbing it at them to cure them, actually.
Cure them.
We're not trying to kill them or harm the zombies, we're trying to make them better. It just looks like Pixel Junk madness. Like, you can create different burgers by throwing things together. I'm in.
Throwing french fries at zombies.
Yeah, I'm sold.
So that's two PlayStation VR games coming out tomorrow in time for Halloween, which is awesome. There's another PlayStation VR game coming out very soon, League of War, and I believe we can see a trailer for that right now.
That was League of War. I'll tell you, those two look like they were having the time of their lives on that couch. I mean, they were all grins and smiles and horseplay. But is it RTS or tower defense, or what is it, Ramon?
It's a little bit of both. So yeah. League of War, you basically can grab a tank, pick it up, and drop it on the battlefield and watch it go and blow stuff up. And who doesn't want to do that? So it's going to have a really, really nice single-player campaign, tons of different generals to choose from, and I really like the use of the social screen.
Very cool, very cool. So, is that it for PlayStation VR then?
No, because you promised.
Oh, yeah, that's right, that's
you
right.
You promised me that I could talk about Monster of the Deep Final Fantasy 15. Unsurprising, I'm a massive Final Fantasy fan, and I'm really excited to get to show you a little bit more. I've got to play a bit of it, and I got to speak to Tabata-san recently as well with PlayStation Access.
So there it is.
Here it is. Now, before I talk about anything else, it is a standalone game. So you don't need to own 15. It's not DLC. It's a standalone game for PlayStation VR. So for anyone who's played the game, you'll recognize some of the locations, but I have been told there's some new ones as well, which is quite exciting because it's a beautiful world. Now, just like it is in 15, it feels quite similar to playing the fishing in 15, almost like sounds daft, but what the VR, you know, would be for the fishing in 15. Different tackles, baits, different rods and lines, put them all together to create the right rods for catching different fish in different locations at different times.
Do they include a VR fish cleaning mini game?
Could you imagine? That would be, have you ever awful.
We've got chocobos now, Carl.
Look! Yeah, so anyone who played Final Fantasy XV's online beta for Comrades will recognize the character customization. It has incredible customization. Best RPG hair I have seen in a long time.
That's important.
You'd expect nothing less from Final Fantasy.
I'm a character customization connoisseur, Rob. You know this.
Yes,
the hair is beautiful. It also features some of the characters you'll recognize from the game. You already saw Cindy. Now, when I spoke to Tabata-san, he told me that the whole team is in it. You know, Ignis, Noctis, Gladio, Prompto. And it actually takes place within the Final Fantasy 15 game. It takes place quite early on. You're basically going out, you meet the guys, and they're like, hey, why don't you come fishing with us? You can come and camp with us as well. The character customization here is stunning. I think the biggest takeaway for this for me as a huge Final Fantasy fan is this VR game here put me into the world in a way that not even Final Fantasy 14 does. it really allows you. You're at the camp with the guys. You're able to steal food off Noctis's plate, and he'd like try and bat you away.
That was like the coolest thing in Final Fantasy XV, the camping. So to be in that is going to be like massive wish fulfillment.
It really was. It gave me something that fanfiction.net has never been able to. It really put me into the world. But it gets better. I'm still allowed to talk about Final Fantasy XV.
Oh my.
Some more.
There's more.
There is. Final Fantasy XV Episode Ignis. We know it's on the way. He is best boy. Do not at me. It's not a discussion. but I'm really excited to be able to show a new trailer for that with some new details. And I can also reveal that the guest composer is Yasunori Mitsuda of Chrono Trigger, which everyone knows. Final Fantasy and music go hand in hand. So I guess we should just get going. Please enjoy the Final Fantasy XV Ignis trailer.
Okay, I guess.
Listen well. A king cannot lead by standing still. A king pushes onward always, accepting the consequences and never looking back. Thing from here. Let's make for the altar.
That actually looks pretty cool.
Yeah.
Well, look who it is. What could one of His Majesty's royal retainers be doing here of all places?
Bloody hell. Join me. I can secure us a way to the king and the oracle. To live and love as you please. Oh, what good is a world that only ever lets you down? Why not end it all right here? I swore an oath to stand with Noct and keep him safe. Whatever it takes, I will protect him. Permit me to make a suggestion. Rather than follow this flotsam and float away to a watery grave, why not come with me? What do you say?
Definitely looks interesting. But given that it's the number 15, it's I hate starting games.
And that was Invector, actually a game that was announced right here at Paris Games Week about 2 years ago. Ramon, what did you make of that?
Very awesome game in a tradition of like Amplitude, Frequency, a little thumper in there. It's awesome, and it is coming to PS4.
Yes, yes it is.
Now, I'm sorry, I'm taking back over. Because that
all right, come on, all right.
Can't stop talking about Final Fantasy.
No, I'm allowed to talk about Final Fantasy. No, it looks incredible, and for anybody who knows, it takes place in Altissia. I don't want to give too much away, but anyone who's played that game, Chapter 9, right? Chapter 9. And it fills in, basically, what happens, and I don't know if you saw it, the ring? Look at the ring.
Let's not give away any spoilers. But we are finally going to get to find out, you know, a big thing about Ignis's story that until now has been a complete mystery.
I mean,
so it's going to be awesome.
There's many, many people speculating on Tumblr, let's put it that way, so who knows?
I can only imagine, right? So, great show so far. I mean, I feel like, I think we brought some significant updates here. Favorite moment, real quick to call it out?
The Hong Kong Massacre. That looked insane. I can't wait to play that.
Yeah, what about you, Holly?
I think it was Gardens earlier on. No, but sorry, I forgot the full name of it.
The Gardens Between.
Between, yes. That's the one, thank right. you. So I know everyone thinks I'm going to say Final Fantasy, but Garden Between, I don't know, there's something about that. That's my jam. Hit good personal deep stories.
Rob. It looks beautiful. I mean, for me, it's got to be the tennis. Mm-hmm. Tennis World Tour.
That's a surprise.
I keep hearing about it, but I've been
waiting for it really deep. I got to be hyped too, but they just
good tennis game for so long. So to have Tennis World Tour coming is proper exciting, and I was, you know, massively hyped for that.
Got to say, for me, it's probably Guacamelee 2. Yeah, so glad that we can get that out there. It's coming soonish. It looks gorgeous. It's got the four-player co-op throughout the entire campaign. It's got enhanced chicken mechanics.
The chicken is the highlight of the show, right? That's why everyone's here.
Finger licking good. I don't get in trouble for saying that. That's right. So, hey, we are almost out of time. That big PlayStation Media Showcase is right around the corner, and who's to say what's going to happen then? But we do still have two more games that we need to announce. So what do you guys think we should do about that?
I think we should announce them.
Should we?
Yes.
That's actually a good idea.
Yeah, that's my grand plan.
So let's kick it off with the very first game we're going to be announcing, and we'll do that right now.
Okay, so another game announcement. It just looks a little bit too out there, but no, that definitely looks okay. Actually, I'll probably need to look more into it, but.
And that was a first look at O-Ray, by the way, is how that's pronounced, if you were wondering. Really just magnificent, gorgeous-looking game, and it's actually coming out a little later today on PlayStation Store.
Yeah. O-Ray out today.
Oh, really?
There you go.
I've been saving that.
I've been saving it.
Beautiful. I thought it was incredible to look at. I got real Journey Abzu-esque vibes from it. It's totally, again, my kind of thing. I really believe with gaming, for me personally, I was very AAA only. I never really considered indie. And then I started adding that in, and I feel like I always compare it to having a balanced diet.
Yeah.
And it's like
A balanced gaming diet.
And these are the kind of games for me that balance it out. So in this particular game, you're exploring the world as a child that can turn into a dragon. You've already seen that in some of the B-roll.
That's an easy sell, isn't it?
I mean, it's really easy sell. The idea is there are these titans within the world, and they have very important jobs, but for some reason they've stopped doing their job. So you're trying to convince them to basically go back to work by going through the world, solving puzzles, exploring. There are mysteries within the world for you to uncover as well. I think it's beautiful, and I'm so excited that it's actually going to be available, you know, today.
Today.
You love the look of this, then you can pick it up.
Buy now. That's what I say.
Or is it a flying?
What you said about Journey and Abzu is, I think, on point.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I was
really
getting those kind of vibes from it.
I think it's just so nice to see, you know, games like this as well coming out. And if you're looking at this and you go, I don't play indies, I was the same as you. Please, just give one of them a go. Maybe you'll discover a whole new library of games. What's wrong with that, right?
Nothing wrong with it at all. I mean, that is beautiful. So, hey, that was O-Ray, and I gotta say, you know, I think we had a lot to talk about here tonight. And I want to thank, actually, all the independent developers, all the publishers who worked with us to put this show together. It's an honor for us to be able to debut and your titles and to be able to provide all these meaningful updates and just exciting stuff all around. But I gotta say, that PlayStation Media Showcase is right around the corner. I want to make a shout out, though, to everyone watching live. We've got a lot more to come after the showcase. The showcase ends, there's more to come. We're going to dive deeper into all those games that you saw at PlayStation Showcase, all the new stuff you see there. Are you excited, guys?
Yeah. I mean, massively excited.
Yeah?
That's what it's all about, right? Yeah. These moments where we all come together, that the audience is already in, you can feel the electricity. I already know from people watching at home as well.
Because we have absolutely no idea.
Oh, yeah, no, I don't know anything.
They keep it under lock.
They keep it here.
It's like, it's like a big sporting event. Like, it is the kind of nerves you feel, like, ready to see something epic and amazing.
And
I can't wait.
Who knows? I mean, it's just, it's literally a couple of minutes from now. We're going to be cutting to that live here in just a couple of minutes. But first, we do have one other thing we wanted to share with you. Now, this is one I've been dying to talk about all night long, but I've had to restrain myself.
Not yet. You can talk about it now.
And just a handful of seconds from now, we're going to talk about and show first details on a brand new game that's from an independent studio, and it's the... It's a new title from a developer that's actually rather celebrated. So I would suggest that we cut to that now, and for all of you watching at home, enjoy the show.
All right. Oh, is this like a sequel to what's that called, like SteamWorld Heist or something like that? SteamWorld Dig or something? Things about it, but never really got into it personally. Coming to PlayStation 4, okay. So is that like, maybe they won't show it as an exclusive. Oh shit, so we're just jumping straight in. Alright, here we go, Paris Games Week. Let's do this. Literally everybody was using their phones to capture the press conference. Can you just sit back, relax, and just watch the show? Like, not even worry about recording. Like, worst case scenario, just have like a stand or something like that. Like, I wouldn't even be bothered recording the press conference. Like, what is that gonna do? Like, yeah, anyway, small rant. Still doesn't make sense to me, anyway. What is this?
Samurai.
Okay, so it's in Japan.
You are a warrior. I can see that.
It's not an expansion for Neo.
Your whole life for this. Lesser men have called unwinnable, yes. But while you were sharpening your sword, do you know how I prepared for today? I learned. I know your language. politicians, your beliefs, which villages to tame and which to burn. So I'll ask you once again, Samurai, do you surrender?
So now it actually looks pretty good. Ghost of Hiroshima. Oh shit, that Sucker Punch's new game.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jim Ryan.
So that just straight up started with Sucker Punch. Wow, I would have thought that would have been a PlayStation experience.
What a great way to open Paris Games Week. Thank you for joining us tonight. It's now 5 years since we launched PlayStation 4, and I still have the honor to unveil a brand new AAA game, the astonishing Ghost of Tsushima from Sucker Punch. And you know what? That's not the last surprise that you're about to get. You've seen the power of PlayStation 4 provides you not only with immersive storytelling, but also allows developers to fulfill their wildest dreams. The great news is that these developers are now extracting more and more power from the machine with increasingly spectacular results. That's why a single creative mind like Toby Fox can deliver one of the year's biggest hits in Undertale. Mm-hmm. Why a small studio like Ninja Theory can take you on a thrilling personal journey with AAA production values in Hellblade. And our own worldwide studios can bring alive Horizon Zero Dawn's breathtaking wilderness in dynamic 4K resolution and HDR. Furthermore, you can expect innovative new dimensions in gameplay as we continue to explore the possibilities of virtual reality. The bottom line is that there is so much power and potential packed into PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 4 Pro that innovation will continue to accelerate and proliferate in the coming months and years. With more than 225 games offering graphical enhancements on PlayStation 4 Pro and more than 100 games compatible with PlayStation VR, PlayStation is already the best place to play. As we will show you tonight, it's thrilling to think there's even more to come. While we continue to focus on bringing you the games you love, we're also focused on expanding the PlayStation community. We're excited about innovation like PlayLink, highly social, easy to play, localized, and fun. We've been thrilled with the success of That's You with over 3 million downloads to date, and see more social and family-orientated games give us an opportunity to expand our reach and amplify our mission to be the best place to play.
Mm-hmm.
The past 20 years have seen trends come and trends go. We're still here, stronger than ever, and well-positioned for the future. The ecosystem of today will be more powerful, more engaging, and more immersive tomorrow. The maturity of the gaming industry is an incredible asset to a dynamic and exciting future for PlayStation. Ultimately, words mean little. Action is everything, and the proof is in the journey into the extraordinary worlds of new titles and new experiences that you're about to enjoy. I think you'll agree that the best place to play just keeps getting better. So let's take a look at some of the most sought-after, exclusive content our industry has ever seen.
This looks like it's something new as well.
Mm-hmm.
Valkyrie Genie. Okay. That looked really interesting. The majority of all these games were in the pre-show.
Where am I?
Let the games begin. Your chains will not hold me down. Break and fall to the ground. Can't tame these lions inside. The power is raining like thunder ready for a fight. These lions inside.
See what's biting, have you?
My name is Ryan Marks. I left London to be a soldier. But then they came for my family.
Man, it's a sucker full game.
And everything just got a little bit complicated.
I'm a professional. professional soldier. Don't take bad man for a joker. I don't want a D-man over, but I'm raw getting closer and closer. Get shit resolved, I'm quick, no glamouring hits, just glamouring grit. I'm on my team, won't quit, I'm a real bad man, I get a bad man hit. Wow, rage,
I'm coming for you.
I get this result,
I'm coming for you.
I show no regrets,
I'm coming for you.
Start talking, you're fucking dead.
Wait, listen, it was all his idea. He wanted...
Fuck me! Today a legend is born, ready for vengeance, ready for war, ready for anything, ready for more. My English gets my death for sure.
I'm coming for you.
I'm coming for you.
I'm coming for you.
Show no regrets,
I'm coming for you.
Damn, that actually looks really good.
As PlayStation VR marks its first year in the market, it's really moving to see how development teams are starting to see the raw power of this game-changing technology. We're witnessing the birth of new styles of gaming, storytelling, and visceral experiences. The future of PlayStation VR is extremely bright, and we look forward to unveiling more in the near future. One of the consistent factors in our success over the four generations of consoles has been the unwavering support of our partners. We were delighted to feature a massive amount of indie and VR content in the pre-show. And now it's time to showcase six games, all of which offer features and benefits unique to PlayStation from some of our most valued partners, all of whom we've been working with from the very beginning. Let's start with a new trailer from our friends at Ubisoft.
Alright.
Folks, it's a beautiful sunny weekend in Hope County. How will you be spending your time outdoors?
Yeah, this is Far Cry 5.
Cadetan's gate is still causing trouble.
Imagine me and you and you with me. No matter how to toss the dice, it has to be.
Destiny 2. I'm assuming it's like maybe some expansion. Yep.
Guardian, what I'm about to tell you stays between us. While we have been fighting, an ancient gate has opened on Mercury, and an army of past and future machines amasses. They intend to reshape the universe in their image. But there is one who has glimpsed this dark future. He was my mentor. Osiris. The most notorious guardian in Vanguard history. Once, his dangerous ideas nearly destroyed us, and he was banished. Now he has returned. But will he be a powerful ally, or bring us death? Are the one thing they have not foreseen. Go to Mercury and find Osiris. Time is not on our side.
Mm. next? Oh, this must be Monster Hunter World. That's actually pretty interesting. Okay, the beta. That must be the 9th of December, so that's... God, maybe a month and a half away. Okay, this is obviously COD. I'm assuming story trailer, maybe? Definitely multiplayer.
Bonus map.
Really? They put just one. Why are you clapping for DLC? Looks alright. Battlefront 2. Get ready!
Thank you to all our partners. It's a real privilege to have your titles on our platform. A key differentiator for PlayStation is its best-in-class development teams that make up worldwide studios. We have a great lineup of exclusive games coming soon, only on PlayStation 4. Let's take a look.
All right.
With Fisk behind bars, what's next?
The city's safer than ever.
Spider-Man?
Maybe Peter Parker can have more of a life.
Definitely Spider-Man.
Are you in trouble? Do you need money?
No, I mean, I'm a little behind on my rent, but no, I'm fine.
Take care of this place. It represents the best part of me.
This is Miles. He's gonna be helping out around
here. For Axe.
Wow.
I'm the one who kept order in this city!
What is this? Devil's breath.
Your city and everything you care about will be destroyed. People will beg you for help, but you won't be able to save them.
Get more backup.
Day one buy. Don't think anything else needs to be said. That's just like not even a thought. That's just day one. Detroit?
You've been gone for 2 weeks.
Detroit.
This place is a mess. You do the housework, the washing, you cook the meals. That's Alice. You look after her. Homework, bath, all that crap. Got it?
Right away, Todd. Aren't you going to school today? I'm sure we used to be friends before I was reset. Maybe we can be friends again.
Very bad. It's all over now. Eddie isn't angry anymore.
This is all your fault!
Wow.
He's coming! He's gonna hurt me! Run! Get away! Or he's gonna break you like last time!
I wonder what the consequences would be if actually the kid kills her, like kills the dad. I wonder if there's any like ramifications, like what if she has like a change in mood after that, or for the good or bad. That'd be really interesting. But no, that looks really good. I mean, it already was a day one fight for me, but I mean that just solidifies as a day one. And now God of War.
Sound more dangerous than that.
Then do not drop your guard. Come.
Father! Oh, shit.
Take that!
Follow me.
Yes, sir.
Is that going to be a release date?
That doesn't sound like a Soul Eater. What do you think it is?
We shall see, boy.
There we go, Horizon Zero Dawn. So this will be the DLC. Didn't show much, but I mean, I guess if you've played Horizon Zero Dawn, you know what you're going to get yourself in for. Oh, this is Shadow of the Colossus.
Abra.
Mm-hmm. Is that going to get a release date? Oh.
Hopefully, we've made one thing clear to you tonight. It's a great time to be a gamer.
Is that it?
To close the show, let's have the first in-depth look at a much-anticipated and exclusive title. From everyone at PlayStation, thank you for your continued support. Good night.
I mean, I can't think anything other than The Last of Us. I mean, what else is there? Unless Hideo Kojima's game, if they're stranding. Those are the games I can think of at the moment. There was no Wild as well. Wild wasn't there. We didn't have Dreams as well. That wasn't there. Oh, this is the the one with the bike. I'm completely forgetting the name of it. He's gone. That's the name of it. Oh, wow. Or is this The Last of Us? Because there's been a couple of women in there. Bitch, don't just stand there, help her out!
Left.
Better fucking hurry up before she dies. So is this Days Gone or is this... Bags. Actually, that car is familiar to the Last of Us teaser trailer. Oh, I was just about to say that that car looks similar to a part in the teaser trailer they showed. So that was Last of Us Part 2. That was a very good press conference. Like, I mean, the things that they've shown previously, they didn't really put too much time to them. Like, they gave them enough time that they got their own spotlight, but not like too much of a spotlight. And then whatever was new, they gave them
enough
time.
Don't touch that dial. Don't touch. Don't go anywhere. We've got a lot more. We're going to get a behind-the-scenes look at a lot of those new games that were just announced today. So stay right there. Very quick. Our panel of hosts here. What
yeah,
did you think?
Why not? We'll stay and watch the rest of
Last of Us 2. Oh my. Yo, every developer out there, AAA or indie, big hats off to you guys for providing that content for the show, for this showcase. That was insane. Thank you so
much.
It looked
like Days Gone, though.
I'm done.
Well said. Holly, what are you thinking?
Despite being knocked over by the Detroit demo, I have to say Concrete Genie, mouth was open the whole time, utterly charmed. I just want to run around that world. I want to create. I want to bring things to life.
That did feel like it's like a punch game.
That's 100%.
Like, low-key, yeah, if you took away the developers,
Rob,
I've got
you say,
names from each
Shadow
game,
Colossus,
and you said which one was the Psycho Punch
gameplay,
game, I'd probably say that
running,
one.
You know, it looked beautiful when it came out on PS2. It still looks beautiful now, but seeing that on PS4 just looks incredible. It's one of my favorite games of all time,
and
on any platform.
And well-deserved. We've got Blue Point on that one, doing what is sure to be a world-class remaster. I'm going to have to go with Sucker Punch. I mean, we finally heard more about heard from Sucker Punch. What have they been up to? Now we know it's Ghost of Tsushima. And actually, we've got a bunch of in-depth developer interviews coming up right now. And let's start with hearing from Sucker Punch on Ghost of Tsushima.
And about 6-7 months later, it came out with First Light. And then about a year from that, PS4 Pro was starting to come out. So we wanted to support that with Second Son and Fetch with First Light and all the cool laser bullets that come with that. But behind the scenes, what we were really working on was trying to figure out, how do we make a new game? Like, if we were going to depart from Infamous, like, it's got to be awesome. And what is the process to get there?
When we were looking at our next project, we wanted to stay open world because we're giving authority power to the player. And we didn't want to walk away from that. We think it's integral to modern gaming that players are in charge.
And I think in true Sucker Punch fashion, we answered that with, hey, what does everybody at the studio think? And we had about, I believe it was 70, 72 pitches and 72 ideas that kind of all formed up from various corners of the studio. And we tried to coagulate that into like one, you know, idea. Turns out these things are really, really hard.
We thought a lot about open world games. and what makes some open world games just beautiful and great. And we kind of settled on wanting to have a clear fantasy as the player. Who are you? What are you going to be doing in the game? And then we came upon this game idea, which is awesomely simple, right? To hear about it is to want to play it. Who doesn't want to go to feudal Japan? Who doesn't want to be a samurai with a katana on their hip, right?
When you tell somebody that you get to play as a samurai, you don't really have to say anything else. You just say that fantasy, and everybody just builds a list of scenarios and narratives and gameplay scenes that you might get to play in that.
Well, story.
When we hit upon the Mongol invasion
of
Tsushima of 1274, it all clicked. Suddenly you knew who the heroes were, who the villains were, what the stakes were for the world, and you had a video game.
I'll ask you once again, samurai. Do you surrender?
Ghost of Tsushima is a action stealth adventure game where you play a samurai in feudal Japan, and we're taking inspiration from the historical point in time where the Mongol army invaded the island of Tsushima.
All those locations are in-engine, they're in the world. That's the place that you're gonna defend, a huge island filled with a lot of different places, towns, people. There's so much to learn, there's so much to see.
I think player choice in this game will mean something very different than other games we've met in the past. We really want you to have that choice of, hey, that cool bamboo forest over there, I really want to check it out. I want to head in that direction and I want to, you know, see what it is. There's no waypoint. There's nothing that says, go here and look at this bamboo forest. And we just hopefully are presenting something that's beautiful and exotic, that's different than the current place that you might be in. And that will come at a world choice, right? Like, that's your adventure choice. Like, it's like, where do I want to go?
In Infamous, we let you explore powers. In this game, we let you explore what it is to be a samurai inside of this enormous landscape of medieval Japan.
You know, here at the studio, sometimes we talk about the world as a character. And I think that even in Second Son, we pushed really hard to make the flavors of the world come alive. There's all these other elements that make you remember what it really felt like to be a tourist in this place. And we're going to do the same thing for this game, starting with some of the shots you see in the trailer. We've been working on this game for, you know, 3.5 years, and it's exciting to be at a spot where we're finally able to share with the world what we've been working on.
And now it's just up to us to actually deliver this fantasy, this wonderful fantasy about being a samurai in feudal Japan.
I mean, it looks amazing. Like, well done.
One of the boldest visions we saw was from a team called Pixel Opus. Let's delve deeper into the magical world of Concrete Genie.
Oh yeah, this is one of the games I started with. What's it like? The second
idea for Concrete Genie actually came from a brainstorming process that we executed with the team, where one of our artists, Ashwin, created a piece of artwork that illustrated a character being bullied. He overcame that by creating artwork within the wall.
So Concrete Genie is a game about a boy who can bring his paintings to life. So all of our gameplay and our unique features are about having fun with paint and using the DualShock 4 to create amazing landscapes, but also make creatures that you can bring to life. And they have all kinds of interesting quirks and personalities and abilities depending on how you paint them. The goal is to make anyone feel like they could be an artist. Is a big part of our player fantasy. It's effortless and it's full of joy, and a lot of our progression
That's
mechanics
good.
In the game are about learning these new techniques for you to play around with and have a lot of fun with.
We're really lucky in that we wanted to use the power and the tech of the PlayStation 4 to make the drawings come to life within the walls.
And we've developed an awful lot of technology as well as design mechanics to help anybody make something as effortlessly as possible in this game. I, for example, can't draw in real life, but in this game, I feel like I can. So whatever the marks that you make with the DualShock as you gesture around in this world, we take that mark that you've made and we embellish it and we grow it into something really beautiful.
I'm hoping that people get that same feeling that they did when they were kids and sort of drew with a crayon for the first time or looked at the first illustration in a children's book. I really hope that people feel that when they're creating their own artwork.
we can animate and bring to life these incredible creatures who all have their own AI and their own distinct look, and they're all completely unique to each player.
It's not just about creating artwork. It really is quite a bit more. It's about the adventure also.
One of the things that we learned from making Entwined was that if we're going to invest our heart and soul in making a game that has a message to it, we wanted to make sure that with this game, we put it into a structure that people were going to have a lot easier time getting into. And so we decided to invest in making a third-person action adventure, because that's a platform that we love. We love those type of games. And then all of our amazing kind of painting gameplay sits on top of that base.
Entwine was a perfect first project for the team. What we learned from Entwine is that we wanted to continue to make games that have an emotional connection with the player. You know, games that have heart. And that's sort of one of our internal mandates, is that we make sure that we have games that resonate with people from an emotional point of view. That's been important for Concrete Genie.
There's something really just intuitively fantastic about making these marks in the world and seeing them come to life as well. I'd say the main thing we hope people will feel is joy.
I feel as an artist, this game is really a dream come true, because I think if you're a young person drawing in the back of the classroom or sketching, and we really give you the ability to have that same feeling that you do as a kid, but have your drawings come to life. I mean, that's is an absolute dream come true.
Yeah, that definitely, I mean, for me personally, I'm not too much of a drawer.
Among the many titles
person,
PlayStation announced at Paris Games Week was one that stood out for its innovative storytelling. It's called Erica. Let's take a closer look.
Games are typically empowerment fantasies about external conflict, and we're putting you in the mind of someone who is a living, breathing person. And so the decisions you're making aren't about high score. It's not about avoiding a game over. It's literally about the soul of this character and wanting to preserve that, and wanting to do
so
what's
it looks
right
like
for
they're
Erica.
Just going more in depth on like other
I think
things.
If you're not familiar
I think we might
games,
actually stop it, because it's pretty much, I'm assuming anyway, like it just goes over, I guess, the games that we already saw that were announced. And yeah, so obviously if you... so obviously the press conference itself is already over, so I think we might leave it off there, because it is pretty much nearly 4 a.m. here, so I think I need to get some sleep. Definitely we'll be making more content in this. Probably will do a full recap on my thoughts. I thought PlayStation did a pretty good job. Quick thoughts, and there wasn't really, I mean, they had obviously one or two games that I guess I wasn't too interested in, but except for that, I mean, you're always going to have those one to two, even possibly three games like you're just not going to be interested in, but as long as that's the only ones, I guess that's enough. Because every other game, if I was liking it, like I was probably, maybe worst case scenario, maybe would pick it up within like a time space of about maybe a couple of weeks or maybe even a month. So that they're all games I wanted to get pretty quickly. So just goes to show the quality the PlayStation have at the moment. I definitely will be planning on making more videos, and definitely will be making a comeback. So please be sure to witness the comeback, I guess. And I'll be doing different types of videos, because I know my channel recently, for the past probably couple of years, has just been straight Let's Plays. I definitely want to do more like opinionated videos, like where I talk and give my opinion and stuff like that. So make sure to stay tuned for all those videos. I did have live streams previously, but obviously the news videos and all that and the opinionated videos weren't there. But I guess wait in the next probably couple days when I get information on news articles on things that are happening in the gaming industry, and we'll see what we can do. And Yeah, but I guess that's pretty much it. I think we'll just leave it off there. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the press conference. And yeah, I guess that's pretty much it. So we've now reached to the end of the video. So if you like the video, please like the video. And if you want more of my content, please subscribe. And I would like to thank you all for watching. Hope to see you all in another video. Thanks.